Now, everyone's approach to alcohol and drinking is different. And whether you have a couple of drinks each evening or only raise a glass on champagne on New Year's Eve, it's always a good time to evaluate your relationship with alcohol and assess whether or not you need to make changes in your life.
Now, of course, World Without Wine, that's the title, a platform with a vision to inspire and support an alcohol-free lifestyle that offers people the chance to do this with its annual Sober Spring Challenge, which I think is fantastic. Mm-hmm. And we're joined via video call now by founder Janet Gourand as we discuss the benefits of an alcohol spring clean. Ooh. Janet, good morning. Thank you so much for making the time to chat to us.
Good morning, good morning. I love what you said in your intro because that's exactly what we're trying to do. We're encouraging people to take a break so they can evaluate their relationship with alcohol. It's something we must do from time to time.
And it's such a pleasure to have you on the show this morning because a lot of people would have had to, you know, change their relationship with alcohol during lockdown here in South Africa through World Without Wine. How can you, you know, see people approaching and navigating the bans of alcohol?
Yeah, well, we've been evaluating what's been going on, obviously, during the alcohol ban. I mean, we are based here in South Africa, and we found that people tend to fall into two categories. If they're kind of moderate drinkers, if they just have the odd drink socially, then they haven't drunk at all. It hasn't really been on their radar, and it hasn't bothered them. But then there's the other category, the person that drinks a couple of glasses of wine every day and tends maybe towards drinking a little bit too much. Mm. Because let's remember, the safe limits of alcohol are just a bottle and a half of wine a week. Anything more than that and you might be putting your health at risk. So that's not much. So these people that are used to drinking regularly, they were anxious about the alcohol ban, so they stocked up. So that means that, you know, they had their wine, they're at home, and they were actually inclined to drink a little bit more because obviously we're all under huge stress at this during this year.
When the alcohol ban was introduced or sort of enacted here in South Africa, I mean, the news was met with absolute devastation and such outrage. It was insane. It was crazy everywhere you looked, Janet. Mm. But why would you then say that lockdown is actually a good time for people to pause, reflect and put down the drink and reevaluate the relationship that they have with alcohol?
Because it's a very anxious time for all of us, and alcohol will increase your anxiety. There's a meme that I love, and it says, drinking alcohol is like pouring gasoline on your anxiety. It makes us more anxious. And in fact, we want to reduce our anxiety during this difficult period. We want to keep a clear head and cope with all the difficulties that are thrown our way.
Level 2 has, of course, brought with it the easing of restrictions, and people are now beginning to be a little bit more comfortable to hang out with their friends and socializing. Why is now the perfect time for people to reconsider, you know, or consider taking on the Spring Sober Challenge?
Well, because we've been confined to our homes for so long, I think the tendency is going to be to party just a little bit too hard. But one thing it will do for you is it will increase your awareness. So that'll kind of keep things in check.
Janet, the whole premise of a challenge is that people then get to challenge themselves to see how far they can stretch, to see how far they can honor their decision to take on the challenge. But there must be major benefits to it. What are some of those benefits of taking part in the challenge, and how can people get into it and sign up?
Okay, I'll tell you how they sign up first in case I don't get to that because there's so many benefits to talk about. Sign up by going to worldwithoutwine.com. Simple as that. You'll see it on the homepage. So the benefits, I mean, we've talked about the main benefit in my view. First of all, it's to check your dependence because 20% of social drinkers will become dependent over the years, you know, so be aware of that and always keep your eye on it. Mm. So physical benefits, I mean, alcohol is so toxic that taking it away for 66 days will have significant health benefits. The first one is sleep. You know, if we're drinking in the evening, we don't get enough cycles of REM sleep. So if we've been drinking a few glasses of wine in the evening for years, we will have built up fatigue. And at the end of 66 days, your sleep will be so much better quality and you'll feel amazing. Mm. Number 2, weight. You know, most of us ladies spend our lives on diets. So, and did you know, I mean, apart from the sugar in alcohol and the fact that we tend to snack when we're drinking, Your body, when it senses, you know, that there's alcohol in the system, it's on high alert straight away. It has to get rid of that alcohol because it's a toxin and it'll kill you if it stays there. So all the energy from the body is about metabolizing that alcohol, which means that often it doesn't even get round to metabolizing and burning up calories from your food. So it's all a bit hopeless if you're on a healthy diet yet drinking wine, because it just cancels it out. Hydration is another nice thing. Did you know that every glass of wine that you drink, you lose the equivalent of 4 glasses of water from your body?
What?
Yes. And that means, you know, your skin is going to look so much better in 66 days because, you know, it makes you a bit red and a bit wrinkly, and your eyes will look brighter. It'll have a big impact on your looks. The liver will take a holiday, obviously, blood pressure will reduce. Did you know, guys, that alcohol is linked to more than 60 diseases? Including 7 different types of cancer and breast cancer. I mean, I've had breast cancer and I was a heavy drinker. I'm sure there's a link there. If you drink 3 glasses of wine a week, then your breast cancer risk increases by 15%. I mean, after that, exponentially.
It really sounds, Janet, like there are a whole host of benefits and too many to even list. But look at you, your skin's looking amazing. You have such an amazing glow. Your eyes are nice and bright. It means you've taken on the challenge. Well done. But thank you very much for chatting to us this morning. I'm going to encourage Kutle to do the same so she can enjoy the same benefits. How's that?
Wait, I just need to clarify, Janet. A half a bottle of wine a week, 7 days.
1.5 bottles of wine a week. You should never drink more than that if you want to be healthy. And one last thing, if I could mention, the joy of the challenge. This is the 3rd year we've done this now. It's the community, you know. We're all on the WhatsApp group all the time, and we have a Zoom cafe every Saturday afternoon, and everybody keeps each other going, you know. It is a lot of fun, I promise you.
Nice. You make friends as well. Thank you so much, Janet. This is fantastic work you are doing. Go on to worldwithoutwine.com for more information.
Thank you.
Now, if you want to kick the habit, now is the time to make a lasting change. If you would like more information for the Sober Spring Challenge and would like to sign up, then head on over to worldwithoutwine.com.